You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
So now I can make some open shapes for the screen left lower side. And again, I'm going to duplicate this layer because I'm going to keep my closed shapes and open shapes in different layers. So Command D, and I'm going to name this open shapes. I'm going to delete this closed shape that's in there. I'll just lock this other layer, and I'll just actually turn this off so it's not in the way, and I'll look for an open shape, which is like a thin piece of hair. Click B, and then Escape, and then R to get into the editing mode. So I'm choosing B splines, but you can use a different spline type if you like. And I don't assign a thickness to open shapes until I'm all done, because if I assigned a thickness, I probably couldn't see the hair. So sometimes I'll just press zero and see, okay, where is the hair? There's the hair. And this is very labor intensive. If you have tracking, then it's nice because the hair will at least come out of the head in the same place, but it moves around a lot. And sometimes it's just very hard to tell. And it usually requires a lot of keyframing, and you can even have a keyframe on every frame sometimes. Then in the end, when I do want to assign a thickness, I go down to the stroke width in the object window down here, and I can assign a stroke width. We'll just do 1. And then if I click A to see the alpha, we have to be in output mode. You can see that I have it there. I'll turn off the overlays, and now you can see my shape. Okay, now we'll move on to the upper screen left side, and I'll show you how I make some arcs. So again here, I'm going to duplicate an existing tracking layer, and in this case it's the screen left upper head core. So I'm going to just collapse these and make some more room. Command D, and then drag it outside the head core and rename it. And then I do not need the core shape in there. I just want the tracking data. So this is usually one of the last steps I do after I make the solid open shapes, or the solid closed shapes, and then the open shapes. I make some small arcs around the head to give it a more natural look. So this is the area I'm gonna work on. I'll zoom in here, and I'll just make some open shapes. Click B. I am looking for real hair strands here, but it's sometimes I just might add a few just to give it some more depth. Click Escape, R for the edit tool. Make sure we click on our shape. And you want to make sure that you're dragging your endpoints well into the head, because if you turn on motion blur later, if they're too close to the edge, then you might see that endpoint. Okay, now that I have a little definition, I can just play it through, and you can see that the hair strands are sticking to the side of the head. And if I decide that I want even more, I can just duplicate these. I'm going to select them, Command D, and they're duplicated. I'm going to lock the ones that I made before, and I can just actually make these three a different color. Make them red. And now that they're all selected, I can just move them as a group. Press T. And then I can go back in and just do some individual editing. so they don't look repeated and the same. And then we have more hair strands. But you can see here that they're sort of sticking in the same place after a certain frame. And that's because I made an edit that was on a different frame from the original frame. So what I can do is just delete these and go back to my original frame here and do this again. I'm just going to select these and move them as a group. And do a little bit of mixing up here. And then we can take a quick look. We'll assign all of these a width. First, we have to make sure that they are all unlocked. Click A. Turn off the overlays. And if you see a little aliasing here, you can just add a small blur. So we'll just go to the blur here. And it smooths them out a little bit. Okay, so that's just another way to add some definition.